Don't come round, but if you do, yeah, sure, I'll be in unless I'm out. Don't knock if the lights are out or you hear voices, or then I might be reading Proust if someone slips Proust under my door or one of his bones for my stew. And I can't loan you money or the phone or what's left of the car, though you can have yesterday's newspaper, an old shirt or a bologna sandwich, or sleep on the couch if you don't scream at night. And you can talk about yourself, that's only normal. Hard times are upon us all, only I'm not trying to raise a family to send through Harvard or buy hunting land. I'm not aiming high. I'm only trying to keep myself alive a little longer. So if you sometimes knock and I don't answer, and there isn't a woman in there, maybe I have broken my jaw, you know, and I'm looking for wire, or I'm chasing the butterflies in my wallpaper. I mean, if I don't answer, I don't answer, and the reason is that I'm not yet ready to kill you or love you or even accept you. It means I don't want to talk. I am busy, I'm mad, I'm glad, or maybe I'm stringing up a rope. So even if the lights are on and you hear sound like breathing or praying or singing, a radio or the roll of dice or typing, go away. It is not the day, the night, the hour. It is not the ignorance of impoliteness. I wish to hurt nothing, not even a bug. But sometimes I gather evidence of a kind that takes some sorting. And your blue eyes, be they blue, and your hair, if you have some, or your mind, they cannot enter until the rope is cut or knotted, or until I have shaven into new mirrors, until the wound is stopped or opened forever.